Gentlemen, welcome back to the 401 Games Original Trilogy X-Wing Tournament here at 401 Games in Toronto. We've been playing all day with this original tournament game. We are now Original Trilogy Tournament, and we are now down to the final match here with Evan Cameron versus Ryan Dvornik. I am Mike Reverso, and my co-host here is...
Stephen Moss,
we are happy to take you through this original trilogy goodness. So just a quick recap for anyone who's just joining us now. This is original trilogy tournament in which every player must bring a Rebels list and an Imperials list, and every match is going to be Rebels versus Imperials. And the only ships that are allowed are ships that are visible in the original trilogy, not the special editions, just the original trilogy. So for Rebels, that's the YT-1300, the A-Wing, B-Wing, X-Wing, Y-Wing. And for Imperials, it's a Lambda Shuttle. It's a TIE Fighter, TIE Advance, TIE Bomber, TIE Interceptor, and the Imperial Fire Spray. So we've got Evan Cameron here running a triple X-Wing list, it looks like.
I'm
liking that.
This is a goodie.
Yeah, this is a fun one. We don't get to see much of this at all. So one thing that you should remember is that while it's original trilogy ships only, this is not like a Wave 3 tournament. So you are allowed using later upgrades.
Which we can certainly see here.
Yeah, which we can certainly see. For example,
BB-8 Wedge.
BB-8 Wedge is great. That I think, is one of the biggest flaws of the T-65 X-Wing. It has no repositioning. Yep. Adding BB-8 on there gives Wedge just enough to really do a little bit of arc dodging when needed.
Yeah, this list has some punch, too, right?
So we've got Wedge. We've got West to strip tokens. The unfortunate thing is, West does have adaptability. So West is actually at PS9 here.
Yep.
So West shoots first, throws on a stress, strips some tokens, and ends up with giving Wedge an opportunity to take a shot at a tokenless, lowered agility ship. And then you have Biggs to keep them alive.
Versus Ryan Dvornik, who is playing a very interesting list. So we've got a Vader with VI, ATC, engine upgrade, and title.
VI is lucky here. That means
PS11.
With or without initiative, he ends up going after Wedge, which is fantastic.
Right, and then we also have Mauler Mythyl with Snapshot. That's fun. Backstabber, and then an OGP with Palpapalps.
Palpatine, yep. So I think the first time that we ran this tournament, we actually banned Palpatine along with TLT.
Yep, and this is a ratted Palpatine.
Yeah, but we did decide to keep Palpatine this time. What does... I'm never familiar with the ships and pilots.
Which one? Mauler Mythyl is an extra die at range 1.
Yeah, both of the TIE fighters. So Mauler Mythyl, when attacking at range 1, roll 1 additional die. So 4 dice at range 1.
Shockingly punchy. If you leave it alone and you don't realize what Mauler Mythyl's doing, very good TIE fighter. Especially with Snapshot.
Oh, and then Backstabber is very similar. When attacking from outside the defender's firing arc, 1 additional attack die.
Yeah.
So range 3 from... three dice from any range as long as you're outside the arc. Which is solid, actually. I like this list.
Well, you start seeing Ryan already starting to split and run Backstabber wide.
Mm-hmm.
Which makes sense, right? I have a feeling he's going to want to loop around with Backstabber, start getting out of arc, and then just laying shots in.
And with Palpatine...
I'm actually a little shocked we didn't see a castle from Ryan.
Just to leave. He did stay put. But I'm actually kind of interested. Like, I don't necessarily know if Palpatine's necessary in this list. I feel like you could probably do better with something else. Palp might keep Vader alive.
It is an odd one, actually. It's probably to keep Vader alive.
Yeah, but I don't know. I just don't think it's necessary. I think you could do better with that 30 points.
Honestly, with this, I probably would have dropped Backstabber for Wampa. Wampa and Palpatine is a wonderfully good combo.
Yeah, so Wampa plus Palpatine. Like, if Wampa was there, but Muller, Mythyl, and Backstabber don't really get anything out of Palpatine. That's what I'm thinking.
Crits. Like, it's just going to be a crit engine, I think.
I mean, if you can add, you know, add an extra hit, sure.
Or he's going to use him as straight defense.
Yeah. I don't know. It seems like a weird choice. If I were Evan, I would ignore Palp for a while. I'd wait until he got out of position, because he's eventually going to have to move forward. Then I would come around at him from behind. I would not charge at him right now, because you're going to take that Omicron group pilot shot.
I don't know if you want to waste your ordnance on him.
No. I would just focus on killing out these guys, because these guys, I mean, even with Pulp, they aren't that hard to kill, right?
No,
only three hits.
Shockingly,
Vader
killable.
Is. Sorry. Shockingly killable. He's only got two agility. So Pulp is probably there to protect Vader, but Vader should be arc dodging like crazy, right? If Ryan's smart, he's arc dodging like crazy. Muller, Mythyl, and Backstabber though should die pretty easily. And I would actually consider going after them first.
Muller Mythyl can get sneaky, right? Mm-hmm. Because that ship is throwing four dice in.
Mm-hmm. An extra die on snapshot. That's kind of fun. That's actually a neat combo. I would go after...
Another non-regen Rebelist. We've actually not seen too many regen Rebelists.
I think
Rebelists.
We saw R2-D2 once today.
Yep.
But I think that's part of the fun of this format, is people are trying different things. So you're not going to see Miranda or Nora.
You're also not seeing the Hawks, so you're not seeing a lot of... in terms of just the lists, you don't see a lot of your really popular, like, Biggs combinations on what people are running it. Like, you're not seeing, like, a Jin Jan with a Biggs. So you're seeing very little regen. I think we saw regen on a Luke.
Yeah, a Luke with R2-D2.
Yep.
And that did not go well for them.
No. Turns out you still can't park it at range one in front of a swarm.
No, you've got to fly that carefully. So Omicron group is
one
now
bank.
Gonna end up one bank, yep.
Yeah.
See, that I think was the odd choice by if I were Evan, I would have taken my X Wings a different way. So as not to face that.
Yeah, I just won forward to victory here. I don't actually know if I would or not. He's banking in. I think he might have to do that. Otherwise, he's going to really let...
He does have bigs. So
those imps get behind him.
Yeah, this is the thing. You joust these TIE fighters. Try and kill them off. If you can get a shot at Vader, take it, obviously. Wedge with BB-8 pushed the limit. He's got that three-action trick going on here.
Yep.
You barrel roll, so you dial in green, you barrel roll, take an action, clear the stress when you move, then you get another action. The thing is, the greens on the T-65 aren't that great. That chap. That Luke list we were talking about was actually Luke with...
R2,
and I forget exactly what
VI'd.
Else.
He was
right.
Really
yeah,
high.
Yeah.
He was VI.
And then Han with VI, and Chewbacca and 3PO. Chewie. With Chewbacca and 3PO.
Old title. Like a classic fat Han.
Yeah. And he ended up facing a Vader plus a couple ties list. So it was actually a very thematic match. It's a shame you missed it. I don't know if these are going to be up on YouTube at any point. I wouldn't put it past the VTTV guys to put these up on YouTube soon. So if they do, they'll be there, and you can check that out. I think it was round three.
Yep, two or three. What we learned was that you cannot park ships in front of us.
Of a TIE swarm.
A crack swarm.
Yeah. That was just a really bad mistake by the Rebel player. Ended up with Luke in a very bad position.
Yeah. The other thing we found out was... Crackshot wasn't around during the old fat Han days.
Yeah.
And Crackshot munched apart that Han very, very quickly. It took all of them to get it down, but it really put Han in a very uncomfortable position very, very quickly.
For sure. Now, let's see what we got going on here. Okay. So,
yeah, the Force does not save you.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's Wedge doing? I'm betting Wedge did a one bank, and if you barrel roll... Yeah, okay.
So
if you did a one bank...
So barrel roll and then a one bank.
Yeah, but then you're facing the wrong guy. I might actually barrel roll up and then one bank behind...
the list?
Behind Biggs and Wes.
This does keep Biggs a little out further out front than you usually want to. Biggs is always nice to kind of have in the back.
You want to make sure he's in range, though, right? Because if he's not in range... Although there's something...
One round of out of range is not a bad idea.
No, because he shoots the other guys... And then is forced to shoot Biggs the turns after that.
Yep. Wes is Wes is an interesting pilot.
Oh, so there's that barrel roll.
No, I would go back.
Yeah, I would barrel roll back. I don't know if he's doing a bank or a straight. Actually, if he's doing a one straight, he's in a good way for taking out
Mythyl. Maybe he's doing a one straight.
Yeah.
Evan's a good pilot. I'm sure he's figured it out.
So he pushes for a focus, gets a stress, does a green forward, so which immediately clears that stress, and now he can take his target lock. And he's going after Pulp? No. Why would you do... Oh, maybe he just wants the target lock now, knowing he's going to shoot Mythyl anyways.
I would have gone into...
Wait, where's his action?
He took the target lock.
Oh, he did. Where's the target lock token?
Oh, his own's going down.
Oh, there it is. Okay, yeah. Not a huge fan of those tokens. They're custom tokens. I can't remember where they came from.
Gold Squadron, I think.
Oh, the Gold Squadron custom tokens. They're really hard to read the number on them.
They are. Yep, I've got a set of them.
Yeah, it's not that great. Okay, so who's shooting who here? Oh, Vader is shooting Biggs.
Yep.
Range 3.
Yep. It's actually good he got the shoot into Biggs. Now is not the time you want to start splitting your fire up. Though, I mean...
But if he doesn't shoot Biggs, if he gets to shoot Wes, that is actually kind of good. Sure, Wes takes a shot now, but meh.
The other thing we need to keep in mind is he's letting this shuttle kind of sit there.
Yeah.
That shuttle throws 3 dice.
Yeah, the shuttle shot is nothing to be... It's not to be underestimated. It's a 3-die shot, and it's easy to get caught in if you're not paying attention. That being said, I would do everything in my power to get behind the damn thing.
Yep.
Once you're behind it, it's useless for the rest of the game.
Yep.
And it's only good for Paul.
And I think we're going to see... Ryan will probably eventually do that, but Evan's going to try to make him pay for it. Or Ryan's going to make him try to pay for it. Like, Evan will try to get behind that shuttle, I'm sure, but Ryan with the rest of his ships are going to make sure he sinks in damage. Uh-huh.
So what's going on here? Who's shooting who?
We should see Vader shooting first.
I'm really surprised he's target locked the shuttle. Maybe he just wants to get those plasmas off on the shuttle, take it out.
I guess so.
I guess it does make a big blocker, right? And that, I think, is actually the most frustrating thing.
I did not see any Landos today.
No Landos. I think we only saw... not on the stream. I didn't see the entire... group of players. We had 18 players, so that's 36 lists. Every player had 2 lists. 18 Rebel lists. It's possible there was a Lando... So, who's shooting who here? That's 2 dice from...
There goes a shield.
I'm confused. Who shot who?
Vader shot Wes.
Oh,
yeah. Shield.
Oh, right. 2 dice from Vader. That's it. So now we are shooting those plasma torps. This is Wes. Shooting plasma torps at... Oof. That is 3 hits and a crit. So 3 shields, plasma torps, so 4 shields gone. On the Omicron group pilot. And so is that focus token. So I guess he's just doing everything he can to kill that thing first. I don't know if I agree with this move. I think killing the TIE fighters might be the better choice. I mean, getting rid of Pulp is getting rid of Pulp.
Ouch. Does he have the focus still then?
Oh, he's got guidance chips, so that explains.
So that's Wedge shooting in.
Yep. And so Shaken Pilot. What was Shaken Pilot again? That's no straights.
Yep.
Or is it when you bump? Is that Stun Pilot? I always forget.
Ouch, that hurts.
So Omicron Group Pilot is down to 3 hull, it looks like. We've got the wrong hull here for the shuttle. He's well placed behind that rock, which is nice. I do like Wedge with BB-8. I think I need to fly that more.
Yeah, it's nice. It's just a little bit of a point sink, right?
Yeah.
Like it's 37 point.
Yeah, it is.
T-65.
Well, I would maybe avoid the plasmas and guidance chips.
Yeah.
Just PTL and BB-8. Good combo. Integrated astromech. So you end up with less. So Vader shot west because Biggs was out of range for Vader. Just out of range.
Yep. Yeah, it was just a range thing.
So, whose shot is it now? Is it Big Shot? Biggs is shooting?
Yeah. Yep. This is Biggs' shot.
Who do you shoot? Do you shoot Vader? Do you try and kill Vader right now?
No. I would pull Mauler Mythle.
Yep.
With Snapshot, I would try to pull Mauler Mythle.
Take him off?
Yeah, it's just going to be annoying for the rest of the game.
Yeah.
And Vader's sinking.
So, who got shot here?
No damage. So this is going to be an interesting next round, though, right?
Omicron Group is shooting Biggs, it looks like.
Did he spend Palp?
I don't know. He's lost his opportunity.
Yeah. Does he have a token for Palp or something like that so he can tell when Palp's used?
What you should do is lay out the die.
If not, I have a token. You should have something so he can track.
But if you lay out the die with the right face up, and then you just like switch it out.
Yep.
That way you know what they were calling. Because you have to use it before the shot. Anywho. Or just put the card out when he's going to use it. I'm just going to go ask them to do that.
Okay, so I'm kind of curious to see how Evan's going to approach this now. He's going to have to kind of decide whether he wants to let the shuttle run or whether he wants to let these TIE fighters potentially get behind him.
He does have a Pulp token. He just forgot to use it in the first round.
Womp womp.
Womp womp. Okay, so what do you do here if you are Evan?
He's going to have to decide whether he wants to turn towards that shuttle now or whether he wants to let these TIE fighters potentially get behind him.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? See, this is why I think you would rather go for the TIEs first. But you might as well kill the shuttle. Might as well finish it off, right?
Yep.
And so what I would do is I would let Wedge do that, right? BB-8, move, target lock, same like before. They both use their plasma torpedoes, so those can be marked off. Can we mark off plasma torps on the chips? Oh, he's got his headphones on. whatever. So I would.
So plasmas I would, have been I would, used, everybody.
I would two straight, or actually just one straight with wedge, and BB-8 move forward, get my focus and target lock.
You'd bank on wedge pulling the palp shuttle.
You don't even need to bank. You one straight, right?
No, I mean like you would count on wedge pulling the palp shuttle.
Oh, to finish him off. Yeah, basically. With three dice, focus target lock versus zero agility.
Shuttle has one, doesn't it?
But wedge. Wedge drops. Yeah. Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
So, yes,
I would then.
Yeah. So I would just let wedge finish him off. Focus target lock. Chances are you're going to kill it as long as you don't get blocked, right? By, say, Mythyl here.
Backstabber's just going to one hard.
Hard one.
Hard
yep.
one.
Yep. Yep. For sure. Mythyl might jump into a blocking position.
Because he can snapshot.
Although if I were
he might.
Biggs, you know what I would do? Is I would take Biggs into a blocking position on Mythyl. You'll take the snapshot, sure, whatever, right? But then Mythyl can't go up to block Wedge.
Yep. Needs to start getting these, Ryan's going to need to start getting those target locks out on Vader so he can start laying damage in sooner rather than later. Because you can't R4-D6 crits.
True. You can only R4-D6.
So what he should probably do is count on his palp dying this round, unless he... Well, we'll find out after he moves.
Yeah.
But call the crit on Vader, so he'll potentially be throwing out two crits then.
Yeah.
And try to line up a range one.
Yeah, I would just one bank with Vader. Just one bank.
Yeah.
You know... anything else is too much of a commitment. And you've got engine and barrel roll, so you one bank
one
and then
fine.
Focus target lock, whatever, or boost if you need to.
Yeah, I think one bank's a good call.
Yeah, one bank, hard one from Backstabber, and I'm betting a one bank, maybe even a two straight from Mythyl?
Yep.
Hmm.
You could do something like a one hard barrel roll back with Mom
but now the Omicron group pilot might be doing like a two bank. Yeah.
Going just to block.
Just to block everything.
Yeah.
Right? But if he did a one straight with Wedge and expected that block, he still got plenty of room to barrel roll, do his one straight, and take out that shuttle.
So I wonder if Mahler Mythyl then is going to be doing... Man, with the PSs, actually, it's kind of tough because you may want to be thinking about doing
hard two for Biggs. That's interesting. So Biggs can actually finish off the shuttle.
It's a nice call.
Oh, you know what I'm hoping he's doing then with Wedge? Oh, he just avoided the snapshot, it looks like. I'm hoping he's one banking towards the bottom of the screen here. So he barrel rolls, then one banks, and then he can just shoot. At Vader or whoever.
Yep.
Nope, that's a two bank. So he's taking the long way around with Backstabber. Not a bad idea.
Well, that's a really nice one hard for next round.
Yeah. Barrel roll gets into a very behind them position. Oops. Still, I think. The hard one would have been great, though, right?
Yep.
Because hard
one, so.
If he was facing the shuttle right now, like, everyone else is going to be in there in some way.
I liked it.
It's a good idea.
It also lets you hard one again the next turn. Like, you can really
and then
be in the way.
Yeah. Now, what's Mythyl doing? Is that a K turn? That looks red to me. That is a 4K. Which is gonna bump. I don't, that was not a good choice.
That is not bumping.
Although,
never mind. Yeah, he set up the point. Yeah.
Yep.
Ouch.
That might block
Wedge
from doing
stuff.
Well, no, but the thing is, Wedge with BB-8 still gets his action before his move, right?
Yep.
So this is not terrible. Wedge can barrel roll, do his bank.
Barrel roll, focus, action.
Do his bank, right? Then he shoots the crap out of Vader?
I guess so. It's an odd call, actually. Like, this is a weird turn.
Yeah. So who's he moving first, Wes or Wedge? Just a one straight.
Oh, boy. I wouldn't have done that.
Ooh. Okay. Actually, no, it's not terrible. This thing's going to die. The shuttle's going to die. Thing is, he doesn't... He's allowing...
Vader to really...
Yeah.
...play fire in.
Because if he had barrel rolled and then one straight, he would have bumped into Mithil, sure. Although he actually might have bumped into Wedge. Or Wes, that is. So did Wes bump? I guess so. I guess Wes just was doing a one straight.
And so Ryan just did a 5-forward with Vader.
Yeah, just ran. Interesting. Surprised he didn't just one bank with Vader, and then if he needed to get out of arc, he could barrel roll. I guess he's just playing the long game here.
I guess so.
You barrel roll.
Well, shuttle's super dead.
Yeah. Thank you. Oh, yeah, that clap. Yeah, we didn't quite catch it, but I guess he just did a one straight with Wes. So the whole list gets shots on the shuttle.
So the shuttle's dead.
And the shuttle will die, and no other shots will happen here.
I guess that's a good turn for the Rebels.
That's an incredible turn for the Rebels.
That's a super dead shuttle.
Is that?
That is a blanked out focus.
Who was that shot? Oh, that was Wes. So Wes just rolled 4 focuses. Now this is Wedge, who's spending his target lock. Who just does 2 hits. So 2 damage on...
Yeah, I think this is an odd... I agree. I think Ryan's moves were just a little different here.
Yeah.
He might have something he has in mind, though. So I don't know.
And then Biggs, 4 dice shot. That is a dead Palpatine. Pew. All right. So that makes Evan's life so much easier for the rest of the game. I really don't know. I don't agree with many of Ryan's moves there. But again, it's always easier to plan from up here on the stream than it is down at the table.
Right. This next round, I'd just turn the list around, to be honest.
K turns for everybody. That's a little close to the edge. I think you could 4K with Biggs, no problem.
I don't know if you necessarily need to turn around with Biggs. You could probably just do like a 1 bank or something like that, or a 2 bank. It just depends on if he wants to turn him around or not. Yeah.
So his problem here is going to be Vader. It's going to be easier to kill him now that Pulp's out of the way.
Yep. Exactly. Yes. Yeah. I mean, like,
the thing that boggles me is that Ryan did not position himself in any way to get any shots that turn, right? Like, Backstabber could have hard won and had a range 1 shot at
Vader. Could have shot, and if the thing is, like, Vader could have shot that shuttle.
Yeah. Like he was going to do that anyway. So knowing he was going to do that, why not
maximize your arcs?
Yeah, get some shots off. Right, Vader could have still had a shot and arc dodge that turn rather than being behind the whole list with no shot. It's a really, really weird choice. And I think it's going to make Ryan have a much harder time for the rest of the game.
I think, yeah, I mean, a 3 bank wouldn't have been bad.
From the shuttle, yeah.
Honestly, probably would have done something like a 1 forward and just turned everything in and make maybe a 2 forward and let people...
Come to him?
...pick... what direction you want to commit to, and then just put as many arcs in range 1 as you possibly can on his ships and say, kill my shuttle.
So see, now Backstabber has to do a K-turn when he could have been facing the right way this turn, right?
Right.
I mean, I probably would have missed the hard one. I'm not an Imperial flyer, so I don't...
Yeah, the one I think would have been nice.
So now Mahler's facing the wrong way. I'm surprised it didn't K-turn with him, because that would have fit. And then he'd have his ships converging again.
It's too hard for Vader.
So we've got a one straight or one bank. We've got Wes doing his BB-8 barrel roll. And focus, probably, or target lock. Then he's doing one bank. Okay.
Yeah.
So Wes is just trying to get to a better position. Just prepping for later. And then you focus just in case. Now Wes, three bank, just running.
Yeah,
but that's okay.
Is,
I'm pretty sure he's out of range.
Alive,
yeah.
You just, and now you can just turn around.
Yeah. So next turn he turns around with all his ships.
Yeah, because why not? And then just keep start one forward in it. Line yourself back up for a joust.
Yeah. I don't know. I think
K turn Wes, K turn Biggs, K turn.
I just think last turn Ryan missed a huge opportunity to get some really good shots off, like some range one Vader shots.
Or used Vader as almost bait, right? Yep. Where it's like hope they take a bad shot on Vader and not your shuttle.
Yeah. Right. I don't know.
But Evan kind of tipped his hat that he was going to, tipped his hand that he was going to go after Palp and made that a priority.
But knowing that, like, you should take advantage of that.
Be right back. I got a refresh
button. Yep. So, Steven's just stepping away for a second, so now you've just got me. So once again, guys, this is the on who? Oh, okay. So Biggs just took a crit, a damage sensor array, it looks like, from Vader. And Evan not turning around this turn also seems like an odd choice, but c'est la vie. Where was I? So I just wanted to remind you folks that this is the 401 Games original trilogy tournament here at 401 Games in Toronto. Hosted by 401 Games and participated in by a lot of folks who are part of the Prototype Toronto League. Prototype Toronto League being the local league here in Toronto. We play at a lot of different game stores in Toronto. And the basic premise is that we play basically every season, you're supposed to play a bunch of games against a bunch of different players, and you're only allowed using each name pilot once per season. So you're forced to try out a bunch of different lists. Basically, the idea is that we like focusing people or forcing people to get creative, and rather than just playing, you know, the next meta list over and over again. So even this original trilogy tournament is in that same kind of spirit. By limiting the ships that are available to everyone, we're getting people trying different things that they wouldn't normally try, or that wouldn't necessarily fly in, say, a regional tournament or a store championship. So here we are with, you know, all sorts of fun stuff, like a triple X-Wings list in our finals versus Darth Vader and a couple of TIE Fighters. So it looks like dials are almost down. I think we're just waiting for Vader's dial. Now, I would probably just be K-turning with everybody here. Vader's going to have a hard time avoiding all those arcs, even with his boost and whatever else he's got going on. So I have a feeling Vader's getting shot this turn. Now, the question is, what do you do? Do you dive after Biggs, try to finish him off? It's possible, so if Biggs K-turns and Wes K-turns and Wedge K-turns, if Vader does like a four straight and boosts to range one of Biggs, he might actually be able to avoid, kill Biggs and avoid all those shots. might be worth it if he manages to just skirt past Wes's arc, I guess, in an effort to kill Bakes. So that's probably what I would do with Vader, is just dive forward towards Bakes. Now we've got Backstabber coming around again. Backstabber hasn't done much, unfortunately, this turn, or this game. Mythil's done barely anything. So I feel like Ryan just really isn't doing much with his TIE fighters. In turns when I thought he would turn around, he's waited, and so he's really taken his time to get those guys coming around. Like, Mythil should have K-turned the last turn. All right, so we've got a K-turn from Wes as well, and I would not be surprised.
On stream, no, I don't think so.
So Iris is asking if any Y-Wings have made an appearance today, and I don't think so. I think it was just that one little exhibition game between Devin and, what was his name? Dave? No, I forget.
I'm terrible with names.
That was a fun thing, though. Oh, that's absolutely right. Mythil was stressed from the failed 4K. Thank you for reminding me. That's why Mythil didn't turn around the last turn.
Y-Wings definitely have been around. They just weren't on stream.
Yeah. Oh, so Vader's turning out, and Wedge decided to turn rather than 4K, which is interesting. So Vader was going after Wedge here.
Why not?
Why not? Had Wedge 4K'd, they'd be face-to-face, which...
Don't have a shot.
I mean, that's a tough choice, right? Do you take that face-to-face situation with Vader? Nope, now you do. Yeah. See, I think a K-turn from from Wedge would have been the better choice.
Doesn't fit.
Nope, barrel roll does not fit.
Yeah.
So he just evades, because Wes has a shot on him, I guess. But, like, Wedge doesn't get a shot this turn. Having that shot on Vader would be worth it, right?
Yeah. Who is shooting?
Wes, I think.
Oh.
That was three hits. So he takes just one crit.
So shield.
Vader takes one shield gone. Yep. But it's a shame that, because if Wes was facing, if Wedge was facing Vader too at range one, I guess Vader probably wouldn't have boosted in. But having Wes and Wedge both shoot him on the same turn,
yeah,
that's a lost opportunity. Right. I don't understand the hard two from Wedge.
Also, I don't know if he triggered his R3A2.
No, he didn't.
With Wes.
It looks like he did not.
Because I would have tried to stress Vader.
Yeah, stressing Vader would be great.
Because why not? Like, lock him down to what he has to for green moves.
But then you've really locked Wes into just doing, like, a one straight next turn, or maybe a one bank or something. Which, I mean, all things considered, not a bad idea where he is right now.
I think I would probably just one bank in the list.
Yeah. But he'd have been double stressed.
Yes.
That's the thing.
I agree.
So he would have had no actions next turn. Tough choice.
Yeah.
Now, so now do you 4K
see
with
this
Wedge?
List? No. Ooh.
I would 4K with Wedge.
Think
so
now I would.
One bank with one straight with Wes, or one bank.
Now you really kind
actually,
of
you know what? No. If he's doing that, screw that. You're hard two with. You're hard twoing with Wedge.
Yeah.
Right, because you're just grouping all three of them up, getting him next to Biggs again.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
So I'm betting Wes is doing a one straight or a two straight. Maybe a one bank, but then he's just facing the rock.
I see something. Yeah, here's a three.
So he's just hoping to get Mythil focused down.
That's the thing right now. You don't want to hang Mythil out too far. Because it's really not like you're only going to really have arc on one target, right? Like,
mm-hmm.
Mythil's going to burn down in a minute, too, if you've got three X-Wings shooting
mm-hmm.
in on
mm-hmm.
him.
For sure. Especially Wes plus Wedge, right? Yeah. Such a good combo. Strip tokens, lure ability.
Yep.
Right?
It's brutal.
It is. It is absolutely brutal. I like this list for a triple X-Wing list, for sure. I mean, it wouldn't really be viable without Biggs, though. Yeah, so the two hearts. So he's just grouping them all up. You focus with...
Oh.
Yep, plenty of room. You've got your target lock somewhere, so you just take a focus. Yep. And then you...
That's the thing. You've already got the cover, basically, from
Biggs. But see, this
Biggs.
Is the thing. Because he didn't turn around at Vader last turn, Vader now is just behind the whole list and just gets free reign. Right?
I wonder if he can line a barrel roll up so he can't shoot Biggs.
I think he might actually already be in that position. It looks like he has Wedge in arc, but not Biggs. But if he's doing this, he's got
Biggs.
Well, now he's got Biggs in arc, and he's going to have to shoot Biggs. Which, I guess, was why you don't necessarily worry as Evan, right? Because you know Vader's shot's going after Biggs.
Now you take your target lock. Yeah, there we go.
But had he not, he might have had a shot at Wedge.
That's kind of what I was thinking.
Yeah. But is it better to kill Biggs here or do, like, two damage to Wedge?
No, I think you do have to kill Biggs.
Yeah, you might as well finish Biggs off. Just
add
one hit.
Crit.
You add the crit.
And there's a double evade. Oh. Evan's dice have been so nasty these past couple games.
Looks like he forgot to add the crit, but I guess maybe they just talked about it. So Wedge has no shot. Wes has a shot against Backstabber, I think they were shooting. Double evades, it's fine, but the token disappears. Such a good ability.
Yeah, this one won't matter. He's not in range.
And Biggs has no shot.
Right.
Yeah. Now I'm beginning to wonder if there's a good list for Wedge as a complement to, like, a more modern list. That was Big Shot, I think.
I know a lot of people have been more... Well, I mean, it wouldn't be a bad thing for the game to just see more T-65s, so I hope there is some combination out there that people just haven't found yet.
Well, token stripping is such a powerful ability.
Yeah, Wes being able to rip tokens is good. Pretty much anywhere you can swap Jess Pava, you can swap Wes, can't you? Wes is floating right around Jess Pava.
No, Jess is cheaper, I think. Okay, where are we?
Jess is right around like 28 points with a little bit of stuff.
Yeah.
You know, it's a decent droid, prime thrusters, integrated, you know, pretty
but
just
a
standard.
But PS8.
So she clocks in at 25.
Actually, if you take the torps off of Wes, put a cheaper, like even just BB-8 on Wes and PTL might actually be not a bad idea. Strip a whole bunch of tokens, have a bunch for defense.
That's one of the nasty things is Wes for a T-65, and that's just kind of a knock on most T-65s in general. Mm-hmm. Outside of Biggs, they get expensive really fast, and the ship's just not that good.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the T-70's a fair amount better.
Yeah.
And...
I mean, it's reasonably more expensive, too, but...
It is.
If you find... the problem is keeping them alive, right? That's the thing.
Right.
Those abilities are great, but they melt unless you have Biggs. And then you've got that guy who's playing Biggs.
If you're a Rebel player, you just... If you're not flying one of the evil ships from Rebels, you're probably flying one of the other ones, or you're not winning a lot of games. Actually going to see a snapshot here? I think so. That is going to be a bad day for Backstabber. I agree.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, one of them is in a bad spot.
So,
like,
Biggs move
or
forward. That's too far for that snapshot.
He has not been great at dialing in that snapshot range.
No, he's not. Yeah, oh yeah, that chap, I fully agree. Biggs is, you don't want Biggs to be too strong, right? So you can't make them too defensive, although...
I agree, Mahler should have moved faster.
The thing about Biggs, like with the Acetuck and all that stuff, there's already so many things keeping him alive now. I really think they're going to nerf Biggs and then give the T-65 some sort of buff. I don't know when or where that buff is going to come from.
Versus me, I don't think they're going to nerf Biggs.
I wouldn't be surprised if they gave him like a once per round or only if the enemy's an arc or something like that. Just to make him a little less ridiculous.
I think the hope was probably something like a cruise missile does gets you around it, where ordnance, like cheap ordnance to help mitigate Biggs's thing might
but then
be what
you
they're
have
going
to,
for.
The thing is, it still makes Biggs like an auto-include in most Rebels lists.
Yeah, once per turn's still pretty good too, because he's still then divide, like, that's still a solid ability. Because when you still want to kill Biggs, like, you're going to have to worry about having to divert your fire once
around.
Yeah, that's
the thing. Only an arc might be better. I don't know. So who's shooting? Vader shooting Biggs.
Ouch. Biggs. Vader just lit somebody up, I think.
That was Biggs, I think. What's going on here?
Is he still remembering his...
Yep.
Oh, good. I still don't know if he added the crit from ATC. I think he rolled that.
Yeah, he rolled 3 dice. And it's possible he keeps forgetting his ATC crits.
It's a pretty good ability that you just give Vader.
That's the thing that makes Vader viable.
And without it, TIE Advance are pretty bad.
Yeah, I'm not going to say anything, but...
our place to say something.
Wes is shooting, what, Mahler? Mahler, it looks like. And Mahler spends his focus. He takes a crit.
Oh, I thought that was a focus, a hit, and a crit.
Oh, I think it...
Oh, maybe that was.
That's a loose stabilizer.
So that's the stress.
No, that's thrust control fire's stress.
No, that was it. Loose stabilizer. Well, that's what it was. Like,
oh,
it
maybe
was,
it was thrust control fire, and I just misread.
Flipped down.
I don't know. He might have added that crit automatically. You're absolutely right. The Flaming Chipmunk. You guys have some excellent usernames, by the way. Another 2 hits from Wedge. Shouldn't he only be...
Takes another damage.
2 dice. If that shot was from Wedge...
I don't know. I've seen the shields pop off.
Oh, maybe they just haven't been adding the die. And they've just been... doing it verbally. Okay. Did Wes... I'm confused, though, because it looked like Mahler rolled 3 dice
this
when
Wes
attacked
This
actually
is no
him.
Longer that bad of a match. Vader is behind Wes and Wedge.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, right? Like, had Wedge K-turned and just faced Vader head-on, he would have taken some damage, but...
That is a range 1 using Backstabber's ability. 4 dice.
Ouch.
Yeah, that's punchy.
This just turned around. Shaken pilot? Yeah. This just turned around quite a bit. No integrated astromech on Wedge either.
Wow.
Because he's got those guidance chips. And that's the thing, right? Like, are the plasma torps really worth the guidance chips?
No.
Right?
Or am I integrated?
Not, yeah.
Integrated for the points is amazing. It's a toss-up whether you want to run auto thrusters over integrated some of the time.
Yeah, for sure.
Because you're only 2 agility.
I mean, my triple T-70 list uses integrated because, as many times as I play that game and, like, really wished I had auto thrusters. It's just too tight points-wise to include them on all the ships. So it's just like, well, integrated, right?
Right.
It's 0 points. There's no reason not to.
Because right now you're going to seize a 1 bank from Vader.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the thing, right? Had he faced him earlier when Wes had that shot, when Wes did that 1 damage to him, Wedge would have had a range 1 shot against a tokenless Vader.
And you're going to see a snapshot from Mauler Mythil. Number one. Whoever we've got tagged on, Wedge, is likely going
to... No, because Mythil has to move first, right? And Wedge can just K-turn behind him.
That's true.
Which is probably
what he's
doing.
I wonder if he's going to dial in something like a one hard.
For Mythil? Actually, you know what I would do here? I would one... So if we're thinking Vader's one banking, I would one straight with Wedge. Right, so you one straight, so you barrel roll towards the board edge and as far back as you can go. Then you do your one straight. Then Vader does his one bank. Doesn't necessarily bump you, but is like side by side with you and you're not pointing at each other.
That's pretty good.
Right?
Yeah, that'd be pretty good.
That would be my choice. Because that's the issue, right? You don't want Vader behind you.
Yeah.
And I'd much rather him beside me than behind me, right?
Yep, this is a question really, I guess, on how many times has Evan flown this list? Mm-hmm. And he's like, that BB-8's on the top of his mind.
Oh.
He's like, you've flown stuff so many times that
when I do BB-8,
you're just used to it.
So BB-8 barrel roll right, one bank left, that's also a possibility
sure.
instead of the straight.
Yep, that's
the reason I was suggesting the straight is you don't move as far, right? So it's possible that Vader gets ahead of you. But the one bank gives you the arc on the TIE fighters, which might be a better choice anyways.
Yeah.
Right? So that might be worth it. You barrel roll back, arc, and then hope Vader just bumps into you. Actually, with the one bank, you might actually be in a position where Vader bumps into you.
Yeah,
that's true.
Ryan really turned this match around. He's gotten a couple nice rolls. But
it could go either way this round,
it
though.
Could.
That's the thing. And I think that BB-8 one bank left is probably a good choice.
Yeah.
So you go as far back,
I think so
one
too.
Bank, and then you're in a position to block Vader. Either Vader gets ahead of you or you blocked him.
Yeah.
Right? Which is a good place to be. Right? A very good place to be.
Yep.
Meanwhile, Wes K turns.
Yes, Wes is going to K turn.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah. That's. Because even a hard. Well, actually, a hard one and a barrel roll from Mythil would block Wes.
Their hard turn is white.
Oh, right, and Mythil is stressed. But a hard two is green,
yes.
Yeah? And a barrel roll? Hard two, barrel roll.
May
might
block it.
Might block the key turn?
Oh, boy.
Hmm.
This is different.
Did that bump?
No.
No?
That went in, I think.
Oh, barrel roll from him to block the key turn? Or maybe just stay right there? Yeah, there he
is.
Blocking the
K-turn. Wow, that was gutsy.
I was not expecting that. I wonder if Evan was expecting it and just did a one straight.
No, that was so tight.
Mm-hmm. And this is what, a hard two? Nope, two straight. Okay.
He's hoping for the snapshot.
Well, he's hoping for the range one. Yeah, he's going to get
yeah,
that
and
snapshot.
And it's not like Mauler Mythil. He's hoping for range one, too.
I mean, this is choices, right? So if you barrel roll... forward and then do the one bank, you can avoid the snapshot.
It's actually kind of not...
Right? And have a focus shot at...
Here it comes.
Yeah.
So barrel roll back,
yep.
One bank.
So he's going to take that snapshot.
I think so.
And hoping that Vader ends up in a...
Yeah.
Yep.
Sure.
Oh, you know what he should have done?
This is actually pretty good because Vader's going to bomb.
So he focused, I assume. Where's his focus? He should have a focus.
Oh, did Mauler Mythil just light this thing up with snapshot?
Yeah. Where's your focus? You've got a focus. Yeah, so you spend it. There we go. And
whoa.
You take hit crit, so there goes
Rip
Wedge's shields. Yeah.
That
now, but what he had done,
kind.
You know what he should have done? If he barrel rolled a little bit farther forward, he could have still gotten his focus and then just bumped into Mythil.
Yep.
Then Mythil wouldn't be able to shoot him with snapshot.
Right. Yeah, I think a bump would have been okay. Oh,
and then he would have had his shot at,
I kind of figured that. He tried to 4K.
Yeah, for sure. That was a really well-placed block.
Yes, it was.
Did not see it coming. So the question is, what's Vader doing? And Vader, I think, is going to bump into Wedge.
Same here. I don't
that
know.
Two bank
like...
or hard two? Two bank. Two bank. Oh,
bump.
He was going to bump into Wedge no matter what.
Yeah.
See, now had he had
on
Wedge.
Calls on Vader.
Yeah. Had Wedge managed to bump into Mithil, Vader still would have bumped into Wedge, and neither of them would have been able to shoot him.
Yep.
Right?
So Vader is going to shoot range two.
At?
Into the back of Wes.
Mm-hmm.
For one hit.
Evade. Wes has no shot. Wedge gets a shot. Range one at Mithil.
Yeah.
Takes him off the board.
Dead.
Oh yeah, the target lock's been sitting there for a while. Nothing he can do.
Dead.
That is a dead TIE fighter. Pew pew.
And that's been a terrible turn though.
No, that's a fantastic turn for
you're down to
Evan.
Wow, Darth like Vader right now is kinda scary.
Hmm. So again, you do the BB-8 one straight. So this is where you BB-8 one straight.
Yeah.
Right? BB-8 towards the board edge, one straight, and then let Vader just end up in front of you.
I would probably two hard here if
with
I were.
Backstabber?
With Backstabber.
Yeah.
You can always one hard back in. I'd be trying to loop around close to that board edge right now, with the idea being that you can pull out with one hard.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing is if with Wedge BB-8ing back and having to move in to try to block Vader,
mm-hmm.
you're going to give up your back flank, so Backstabber is going to roll those dice.
But, I mean, it depends on exactly where Backstabber hard one? No, hard
I'd
one.
Hard two.
Hard two. Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Hard one would work too, but I think I would hard two, just to try to keep further, like try to get around that arc.
Yeah, yeah. But Vader's, but even if you'd done one bank, you would have bumped Vader.
Yep.
It's just a shame that Wedge didn't also bump Mithil.
It's the question now.
But Mithil died
want
anyways.
To really sink into Wes,
yeah.
right? Because Wes is stressed and not facing the right direction.
Mm-hmm.
I think if I were Evan right now, I would move slow with Wes. Like maybe do a two just to clear it.
Clear
so you get
stress.
Your action. Yep.
And then hope that Backstabber's gone the other way.
Yeah, and to an extent, basically, then line up a really good shot for Wedge.
Yeah.
Onto Vader. So if he's going to go after Wes and probably kill Wes, you might kill Vader.
Mm-hmm. Vader's such a good arc dodger here, though. This is a tough choice.
Fork it. It's tough for me to tell how good the...
There's plenty of room
the
to do
arc
a K-turn
is.
There. That's actually not a terrible idea for Vader.
4K would be pretty good. Pretty good.
So there's that hard... Nope. Hard one. Okay. Yeah. Just prepping for Wedge to be there. So, yeah, I would just Wedge one straight right into Backstabber.
Yeah.
Because Vader hard turns. So Wes just one banks.
Yeah.
There's a stress.
Because Wes is going to too hard the next round.
Takes a focus.
Well, let's see what happens, right?
Yeah. I'm so curious. 4K as to
would be not bad.
Although the barrel roll one straight might actually block it if he does. He's not barrel rolling. Oh, okay. You know what?
He's going after that TIE fighter.
Good choice. Because, again, Vader's either going to bump into him or go past him.
I don't know if that actually will block anymore. They're not. They weren't parallel or perpendicular.
No. Vader will bump into him if he banks, is what I'm saying, right? So if Vader banks one or two, he'll bump into Wedge. If he's going straight, he'll miss Wedge.
2-4 barrel roll back might still be okay.
Does it have a one forward?
No, it has a...
Nope. That's a bump. Huh.
That is
an actionless Vader, and you have no shot on him. Oh, no.
And it's also shooting into the back of Wes.
But with no tokens. That's
right.
That's just two naked dice.
Yeah.
That is the best.
That's true. That's about as good as it's going to get.
That is the best Evan could have hoped for. So Backstabber is going to take a range.
Sorry.
First, Vader's going to shoot range two into Wes. Blanks.
Whatever. Yeah.
Yep.
Happens. That's why you have modifiers.
Yep. And now, Wedge is going to shoot Backstabber. Four dice. Focus for three hits and a crit.
That's,
and he only has two dice.
Takes two.
So he takes hit crit. That could still kill him.
Yep.
If we get a direct hit or a major hull breach. Hit, and what do we got? There's a good chance of a direct hit here.
7 and a 33.
That is console fire.
Console fire, that's not good either.
No. Well, it means your action next turn is spent preventing yourself from dying. It's just Vader. How do you get Vader here? Next turn you K-turn with Wes. That's really close to the board edge.
I too hard with Wes.
Well, what are they checking here? Oh, if Backstabber has a shot.
I don't think so.
Yeah, I think they decided he does not. Do you hard two with Wes?
I would.
No.
Because I don't know if that K-turn fits. It's always weird looking on stream.
I'm pretty sure it fits. Pretty sure it fits. And then as for Wedge...
K-turn.
Wedge? K-turn? No.
I would K-turn with Wes. Wedge?
Is Wes Wedge stressed?
Yes.
Oh, he PTL'd last turn, didn't he? But without the barrel roll, which means his options are limited this turn. He doesn't get a barrel roll this turn. So I just won bank with Wes.
I would too. Yeah, I go for the
Wedge.
Block. You can potentially just block everything.
Yeah, Wedge is stressed from PTL. So that's the trap with BB-8 push the limit combo is sometimes you've got to PTL without using BB-8.
Does 3K fit for Backstabber?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure.
That's out of order. That's not a bad move either. If we're positive that one fits, that's pretty good.
Is that a K-turn? Looks like.
3K? No.
Oh, no.
I obviously maneuver very different than Ryan. It's the one thing I get. I can't predict.
I'm not predicting his
what
his,
he's
his
doing
moves.
At all.
Oh right, console fire. Can't forget console fire.
That's true.
Yep. Sorry.
He just bumped.
But he bumped, so he still gets no action. I guess he was hoping not to bump. Okay, so Wes just runs. Just a one straight. From Wedge, which is smart because Vader's just going to bump into him, right? There's no combination of moves here that gets Vader not bumping in or has arc on Wedge, I think. Now you take a target lock on Vader because why not?
Yeah, in case Vader went really aggressive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so he just moved his target lock over to Vader.
And he did.
There you go. Good call, Evan. Now, Vader could barrel roll out of that situation, I think.
Yes, he could. Yeah.
What I might actually consider is just barrel roll boost so that you're as close to Wes as possible. And who cares about avoiding Wedge's arc? Kill Wes, right?
Right, you've got shields right
now.
Yeah,
you've got a shield. But see, barrel rolling this way and back, you're out of arc. Maybe. Yeah. Okay. So just focus.
Yeah, I think he's fine.
Yeah. Or a target lock, actually, not focus, because you want that ATC shenanigans. So, Vader shooting. Hit. Add a crit for.
So, a crit.
I think the crit's on the side there. I think they put the die there. So, a crit hits Wes.
Structural damage? PS zero?
Yeah.
Wow, Evan's dice are hot, though, man.
Yeah.
Two natty evades.
So no shot for Biggs, or for Wedge, that is. I keep getting the names mixed up.
Yep. This is what you needed.
That one straight was definitely the right choice. Problem is Vader can keep dodging these arcs, right? So what do you do this turn? You BB-8, because you can this turn. BB-8 back and one bank, right?
Yeah.
And then Vader either ends up pointing at the corner with nothing to shoot at, or ends up in your arc.
Yep.
Although Vader could K-turn to come at you.
Sure could, but he's not going to.
No,
Vader's going to hunt down and kill Wes.
I'm kind of surprised that Wes didn't K-turn.
To try for range one.
For Vader?
I'm not sure if they rolled for console or not. They're kind of keeping its and bits a little out of our camera range.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Well, he's still alive, so we'll assume they did.
That's still showing up, though, for me, so I don't think so. Well, yeah, they need to pay attention to these crits.
Yeah. As for why Vader didn't barrel roll forward to get for range one, then he would have gotten shot by Wedge. So that's a tough choice. Do you let yourself get shot by Wedge?
Oh, that was ballsy.
Mm.
A one bank from 4K. Vader is going to
decimate
really
Wedge. Yeah.
Decimate Wedge.
But what did Vader do? Two bank. Oh, that's a bump. That is a bump. Well placed, sir. Good call. Yeah,
yes.
Wes got the PS0 crit last turn.
The other thing, though, right now we have to remember, though, Vader still has his target lock, so he's still guaranteed a crit.
Yeah, Wes is boned.
At a crit. He's dead.
Yep, he takes a crit, and...
Did he just roll
dies.
Another set of two evades?
Yep. Yep, he did.
Okay. Man.
Those dice have been hot, yeah. Yeah, for sure. I would have K-turned West last turn so that he got a shot rather than be facing the board edge with just getting pinged at by Vader.
Yeah, agreed. This is a tough position right
yeah.
here.
I mean, Wedge can kill Backstabber easily enough.
Actually, yes. Wedge would put him at more points. If he can kill Backstabber, Vader's going to have to turn around. If he PS kills Backstabber, he'll be up on two, by two.
2 points, yeah. I mean, Wes kills Backstabber this turn. That is the plan, right? I would just...
I'd one.
Although your K turn... sorry, you're stressed again. So, yeah, you just two forward. No, one forward.
I'd one forward.
You one forward so that nothing Vader does can get behind you. Did they miss console fire?
I don't know.
Have they missed it again?
That's a really big thing to miss, though.
Yeah. I'll go double check.
Yeah, so we've got one of our announcers going to check, because console fire is kind of a big deal. He's dead.
Yeah.
Yes, they did miss that console fire.
So they had
fire.
Missed the console fire. I just went over and reminded them. He rolled two dice. He did not roll a hit, so he was safe and alive, and now he turned it down.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why you use critical hit tokens.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, hell, I forget sometimes when the hit tokens
same.
Are there.
But, like, just give yourself as many opportunities as you can.
And that's something, like, I don't feel bad about going there and reminding them, because
so we're going to see Backstabber likely die.
I mean, yeah, Backstabber should die. Vader's in not a position, but this barrel roll back puts him in an excellent position
too
to
hard.
Follow Wedge next turn. Did he PTL for a focus target lock? Yeah, he did it again. That's not worth it.
I agree.
Not worth it. You really want that BB-8 option.
Yeah,
right?
And
you
really
want
to be able
stressed.
To turn around now too.
Yeah, you really want that. You really want to not be stressed, because you can't you can't barrel roll before you move. Which is bad news. So, Backstabber's dead.
There's PS kill. Oh, yeah, you're right. I don't like that. That just wasn't necessary.
Yeah.
I guess it gave you a sure thing, which is what he was really going for.
Yeah, you don't
want
to take the shot from Backstabber, obviously. But now, like, Vader's going to, what, like, hard two?
He's just going to hard two.
Yeah, Vader's going to hard two, and
I'd
then has
book it with
boosts.
A hard four, or, like, get out
four
of
straight?
There. Yeah.
The problem is... Yeah, that's the thing. No green maneuver,
so.
But you really want to clear that stress, which is why that PTL last turn wasn't really worth it, because now...
Oh, no. That's... No.
Yeah, he's boned, right? He clears his stress, but he doesn't get to barrel. He doesn't get. He only gets the focus.
I wouldn't have tried to clear stress that round. Yeah. I would have gone for maybe like a three hard and try to duck back into the rocks.
Mm. And then, but then Vader just boosts this turn, and then next turn it's the same thing, right? So like, yeah, he's really not in a good space, and he's gonna take this beating, right?
With only three hull. And yeah, no integrated.
Like he could lose this turn. Very much.
Ouch. Add a crit.
Ooh, that's not bad. You add a crit, and you evade, and you're safe. So thank God for that.
Takes a crit.
Thrust control.
Stressed, flip
it
down.
No.
Ouch. Oh, no. one forward, actually.
Wait, did he have focus and target lock? Was the target lock there from last turn?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That makes sense. So what do you do? You one forward. Yeah, you one forward. But you're stressed, so...
One bank?
No, but so...
No,
here's what I do with Vader, right? So if Wedge one forwards, right? That's what I would assume Wedge is doing. I just hard one with Vader and then barrel roll behind him, right? It's the only way to stay behind him. And I'm pretty sure that would work.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah. So I'm pretty sure Evan is boned at this point.
Yeah, this isn't good.
Because he doesn't really have an option that keeps...
Oh, and that BB-8 would have been so good.
Yeah. Vader has no hard one? Is that right?
Oh, well, I think a one bank might fit in that, though.
Oh, yeah, one bank fits, that's for sure. Yeah, and there it is.
Ouch.
See, using PTL, getting yourself stressed, and closing down BB-8 just limits you so much.
PTL has a heck of a limit. As strong as it is, it
you
really does have
careful.
A solid drawback.
You really, really need to be careful, especially with the BB-8 build, because that's what's keeping Wedge alive, is his ability to barrel roll and do those, like...
Oh, wow. Adds a crit.
Yep. And another crit. Two evades. He takes two crits.
Dead.
And
that's game.
One, two, game over. There it is. So,
and the winner of the original trilogy tournament is Ryan Dwornick.
All right, so three cheers for Ryan Dwornick, everyone. Evan put up a good fight, but man, Wedge just could not get his handle on Vader, and that's why you really got to take care of Vader early on if you've get the opportunity. And I think Evan gave up an opportunity when he really could have done it.
I do too.
Which is a shame, but I mean, hey, great job by Ryan. That was
great game.
Very surprising that he managed to pull that off. I feel like Evan made a few mistakes that could have taken out, really could have taken out Vader earlier on. But c'est la vie.